Yeah, why did she suddenly die? Who killed the High Priestess? Zircon gem. Like he gave a command. To his underlings and they're like, kill her now, and then it happened.
Stand back for justice!
That reminds me, we've never been in this door either. I'm surprised we didn't fight any things on the way back. I wonder if these guards have anything new to say. Probably not. Because I'm pretty sure that's what she wanted to do. And I was gonna... Sorry about that. I was gonna ask her about that. But I can't, being she's dead. Maybe that's the point. Right. High Priest Ascendantili has asked me to go to the rebel Prince Villanati and help him save the Sahuagin from the Mad King. She has given me an orb which I should keep in my possession when I leave the city, and the rebels will see it and bring me to the rebel prince to talk. Otherwise, I could just killed the prince and his guards and the priestess, senior priestess, and maybe get a reward from him. But I don't know. This king is kind of out there, so I don't think he should be trusted. In fact, he's insane, so I'd trust him even less than the prince. All right. Let's see what happens.
See battle, Bo! Run, Bo! Run!
No battle yet.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
I just want to hear what the prince has to say. I mean the king. Oh, okay. Send my favorite little surface elf to speak to me. It didn't work.
So the bigger they are, the harder I hit.
Well, I also have 18 charisma, I think. No, I have 15.
Fine.
Oh ho, it is my surface elf. Come to me once again. And does it have... Why, yes, I think I smell the ichor of a rebel. You have the heart with you. Yes, 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 yes! I knew this was coming. Yes, I did. My men reported your return, and I asked Sekala if it was done, and he told me that it was. Okay. So I sacrificed a few hatchlings and a guard to the Shark Father, and I had the rest of the guards prepare for the festival. There will be a feast tonight. On us? Oh, not. Not that we're planning on feasting on you, my favorite little elf. No, no. You weren't planning on eating my elf, were you, Baron? Oh, I forgot about the Baron. No. I wasn't planning on it, most honorable Ixtlilatokal. Alright, they took the heart. Liar. I heard you talking earlier. So be a good Baron and get the reward for my little elf here. It has certainly deserved one. Oh, yes. Captain... Man, these names are insane. Captain Al-Yittel says, Most Exalted One, alarm, alarm, the rebels, the prince, they have crept into the City of Caverns and they are attacking. What? You have betrayed me, my elf? This cannot be. Baron says, I told you that the surface beast could not be trusted. King says, oh, shut up, fellow castle. Just kill them. Kill them. I want all of their heads on my plate. True, I guess I should have expected this.
But kicking for goodness!
Alright, Minsk.
Such menial tasks.
Oh. I don't want him using that. I guess I'll put the orb away. There's the king.
Minsk, where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Flame strike on the king. And bolt of glory. Critical miss. Whoops. Well, the king's dead. I get the heart back. Some kind of magical spear. Magical rope? Hello. Sahuagin treasury key. Nice. I like. Actually, let me get some more minute meteors. So where's the Baron is over there. Thinking about it. Never mind. I'll send her in and melee a little bit. Actually, here, have a cure serious.
What? What can I do?
You can do great many things. I don't know if they seem to be just standing around again. I don't know if they're attacking from range, necessarily. Hog. Oh yeah, throw another healing in. Oh! There's Prince Villanati.
Trust is dead.
He has nothing to say. Get the Baron.
Every hamster has his...
I have had to drop what you gave me. I have only 2 arms and no more space.
Armored, sharpened, and raring to go.
Alright, so for the Baron... Bolt of Glory.
Your life shall be mine.
Nice. We got experience for the death. Good. That's what I wanted. I didn't want him to take the XP from me. So it looks like he's heading over to this one. So we can go attack this one.
Caverns.
The Mare Tyrant is dead, and we are well rid of him. May Sekala gnaw upon his bones for an eternity. You have done our people a great service, Elf. I'm used to him saying surface, Elf, so that kind of messed me up. Senior Priestess says, greater perhaps than you even know. With Ixtlilotokhl dead, the exiles can now return to the City of Caverns, where once our people grew weak, now they can become strong again. Ari says, is that what we've done? They sound like they're going to take over the world, but there's so few of them now. I suppose anyone can dream after all. The Senior Priestess says, their blood will return to mix with the old, and only together can we protect our city from the advances of the Illithids and the Drow. Ixtlilotokhl was too mad to see what he was doing. The Prince says, and now the City of Caverns is saved. The prophecy is completed, even if not quite the way that pale eel thought it would be. Huh? Call him an eel. I want to get into this. We owe you a debt, Elf. We are unfamiliar with your kind, but you are welcome amongst us, and you did more than what was asked, bearing the brunt of the battle. You know, I killed dozens of your rebels before. Did I say that out loud? For that, I give you the first spoils of war. Take the treasury key from Ixtlilotokhl's corpse. Oh, that's right. Yeah, that's the key of that door. Use it to enter the city's treasury and take what you will. Nice. I am feeling generous today. To enter the Underdark, you need the magic rope from the king's corpse. Got that too. Use it to go down the pit behind my former throne. Wow, and someone leveling up. Airy, nice. The Mad King of the Sahuagin is dead, and the Rebel Prince Villanati has assumed their throne, thanking me for helping to restore the weakened Sahuagin to strength and saving their city. He told me I should take the treasury key on Ixtlilotokhl's corpse and take whatever I wanted from the treasury as a reward before I go to the Underdark. Wow. And I'm looking forward to... never pronouncing this name out loud ever again. Yes, like an Aztec name or something. I think before I said Mayan, but I think it more resembles Aztec. Before anyone says anything. These episodes are recorded before you see them, so. So treasury key. This ornate key will open the door to the royal treasury. Give that to our roguish type. Unidentified bolts. And spear. This enchanted rope allows the user to descend or ascend any height. It will stretch to any length and still maintain its length. I mean, its strength, sorry. It can be used to descend into the Underdark through the hold at the Sahuagin Guard. Huh. Nice mince. Well, Minsk already has it. Not sure. Yeah, it still says with luck. I'm gonna put it in the bag of holding. Scroll of Fire Shield Blue. Yeah, we don't need that. Bolts of Biting. Mass Invisibility. Wow. Level 7. Oh. They should call it Mass Improved Invisibility then. Really just doing it for the XP, since I don't have her use spells, really. It is copied. Okay. So you level up Airy, and I can go in there. I wasn't able to identify that. Hold on a second. Oh, maybe I had it on the wrong person. Vlad the Impaler. Impaler plus 3. The Impaler has a palpable aura of magic that hints at the vicious nature of the weapon and why it has been a favorite of several orc chieftains in the past. When a victim is struck, they are, as one would guess, very nearly impaled, run through as the massive enchantment does its dirty work. Wow. 1d6 plus 3 damage, plus 10 piercing damage, attack go plus 3. Not usable by cleric or mage or thief. And Minsk is the only one that can use it, but he's not proficient in spear, so I'm going to put it in there. Okay, leveling up. Right now she's a cleric and mage, level 13. Okay, we got a cleric level. Additional priest spells, 4, 5, and 7, 1 hit point. Why bother? 1 hit point. But yeah, that is second edition rules for you, and maybe beyond, I'm not sure. Because these are high level characters, relatively. Okay, so, well, I say 4, 5, and 7, right? So we got an additional... So I could put an additional Cure Serious, or Lesser Restoration, or pick a new thing. Cloak of Fear we have. Death Ward. This would really be good against Beholders. I don't think I used it when we were fighting the beholders and the eyeless, the cult of the eyeless. That seems pretty nice. Pretty neat. +2 bonus to armor class. Free action though. Web hold, person grease, and entangle. I wonder if it also dispels. Or if it only prevents. Holy power. I'm not gonna have her striding into battle. Negative plane protection. Let's give her a negative plane, yeah. Alright, so here we've got chaotic commands and Ray's dead. Champion strength. Yeah, it would reduce Minsk, that's why I don't bother with it. Well, we can put in Cure Critical or Flame Strike. Either one of those would be useful. Greater Command, Magic Resistance, Mass Cure. Righteous Magic. Lay living. Okay. Yeah, flame strike. And now, nice. She has access to these spells. Level 7. Confusion. Earthquake. Duration, 3 tremors. Huh. When the spell is cast, a local tremor of fairly high strength rips the ground. The shock is over in several rounds. The earthquake affects all creatures in its area of effect. There are 3 tremors that are caused by the earthquake. First, all creatures affected take 6d6 points of damage and fall to the ground for 4 rounds. A successful saving throw versus spell with a -6 penalty halves the damage and negates the fall. Second, all creatures affected take 3d6 damage. Successful saving throw versus -2 penalty halves the damage. And third, all creatures take 2d6 points damage. Successful saving throws halves the damage. The spell will affect both enemies and friends of the caster, so care must be taken in its use. Finally, earth elementals dislike mere mortals toying with the land, and there is a small chance that casting a spell will cause an earth elemental to appear and attack the party. Yeah, maybe I'll come back to that at another point. Finger of Death. Firestorm. The whole area is shot through with sheets of roaring flame and then pelted with fiery balls of lava. Lasts for 4 rounds. Continue to do damage to the creature during that time unless they move out of the area of effect. No saving throw. Nice. 2d8 points of damage plus 1 per level of the caster. I like Firestorm. Oh, now she has Gate. Could you imagine summoning 2 pit fiends? They probably just attack each other. Greater Restoration. That's a good one. Holy Word. A small explosion centered on a piece and reaching up to a 15-foot radius affects only enemy evil creatures and undead. Casting time of 1. Wow. That are caught in the area of effect. The effects vary depending on the target's hit dice. Less than 4 is death, 4 to 7 stunned for a turn, 8 to 11. Slowed for a turn with 75% chance of spell failure and 12 and up. Deafened for 1 turn with 50% chance of spell failure. Cool, there is no saving throw. The effects are instantaneous and last for the duration of the spell or until dispelled. Spell may not be cast by any priest of evil alignment. So Aerie can cast this, but Faconia cannot. I'm just going to put that there for now. Regeneration. Handy. Resurrection. This brings back so they're ready for the adventuring life right away. Faconia has that. Alright. So I'm going to leave just Faconia with that. Now, Shield of the Archons. Spells cast against the priest are absorbed and consumed. Excludes area effects. Sunray. A ray of sunlight beams down upon the caster and everyone in a 15-foot radius. All creatures within the area of effect take 3d6 points of damage. Dropping out again to desktop. Okay, those are my two drops. Now I'll reset. Undead are hit by sunray, take 1d6 damage per level of the caster and must save versus the spell to be destroyed. I think that this one's more useful. Because it will not... Actually, it'll hurt Faconia, but it's not going to hurt the rest of us. Death symbol? Or symbol, comma, death? I like it. Powerful enchantment allows the priest to inscribe a symbol on the ground or any other surface. The symbol will remain there until someone comes too close, at which point it will explode, causing all those within the area of effect to make a saving throw versus death or die. Creatures with more than 60 current hit points are immune to this effect. Symbol of fear and symbol stun. Yeah, similar, I'm sure. Okay. So I'm going to keep Holy Word.
I am yours to command.
Oh my.
This is a lot more exciting than any circus.
Yeah.
Shaw guides my hand.
Let's see what they have to say now. So, Hoogan Chieftain.
A simple matter.
I am most grateful, Surfacer. My people shall thrive now that we exiles have been restored. We shall not have to flee from the drow to the black depths of the ocean. I shall take my mother's place and be the High Priestess for Villanati as he restores the City of Caverns. You have done well, Elf. May Sekala bless you with the strength for your service to us. Where are you going?
You shall always be welcome. City of Caverns, surface creatures.
I hope your journey in the Underdark goes well for you. Huh. Thank you.
Hey, jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
You can run up there.
Time to move? Gotcha.
Oh wait, see what he's doing. He's looking at the remains. Oh! Priestess of Sekala! D- death ward?
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Yep, good to go.
She cast death ward, not you.
Right you are.
Stand back for justice.
No mercy for those who oppose us!
Next time.
Okay. Zircon gem. Not just an outlier?
Fine.
I was trying to peel back the fog of war to see more of the city here, but... I mean, we can do it with a spell, but... I'm weird. I consider that cheating. Clairvoyance spell.
See battle, Bo! Run, Bo! Run!
Actually, I'm not completely sure it's in Baldur's Gate 2. Alright, well, let's enter. See what they have in the treasury. Exciting! Well, there's like two doors? Oh! I thought we were gonna go inside here. Okay. Protection from the elements. Sahuagin scribe notes and some kind of rod. A rod? Rods are very powerful. Is there we all stand to use? Learn this. Level 7. Protection from the elements. It confers 75% resistance to all elemental attacks such as fire, cold, and electricity, whether magical or non-magical, from spells, weapons, wands, breath weapons, etc. The effect of a protection from elements spell lasts one round per level of the caster until dispelled. I'll learn that. Thank you. Attempting to learn. Failing. That's the one thing I don't play with. Yeah, you failed to learn the scroll, it's gone forever, and you might never find another one. I don't. Homie, don't play that. Alright, it is so copied. And then, so Sahuagin scribes notes. This scroll seems to be a collection of stories about great wars of the Sahuagin. They mention planned offensives against land dwellers all along the Sword Coast, as well as tales of past offensives. The Sahuagin appear to be a particularly warlike race, constantly planning full-fledged invasions of the shores, but rarely following through due to incessant infighting. The events that you have seen in this particular settlement would seem to bear that out. An interesting insight into Sahuagin culture. Copied it. And then we've got a Rod of Lordly Might. Also called the Wrath of Three Kings. Though not associated with any named king in particular, this rod was likely made in 1090 DR, Dale Reckoning. It saw use during the Battle of the Bones, but for which side is uncertain, as it was found amongst the dead after a larger skirmish. Three buttons unlock the rod's magic. The first transforms it into a fearsome enchanted mace, the second a hypnotic flaming blade, the third a barbed spear. Only warriors can properly use its exotic mix of weaponry. Wow, different buttons. Mace, blade, and barbed spear. This rod may transform into any of the following weapons when used. Each weapon may also change back into the rod at will. So the mace, plus 2. Target must save us a spell at plus 5 or panic for 4 rounds. Attack plus 2, damage 1d6 plus 3. Flaming longsword plus 1. Target must save us a spell at plus 5 or be held for 5 rounds. Plus 1, damage 1d8 plus 1. And the spear. Target must save us a spell at plus 6 or take 2d4 points of magical damage. Thaco is plus 3, damage 1d6 plus 3. Alright, so Minsk can use it. I mean, yeah, you can. I'm actually going to put it away, sad to say, because it's just... I mean, He's not proficient in spear or mace. And if I put it to a flaming longsword, which he is proficient with, it's only plus one. Then again, every time he hits, I'm guessing this is upon hit. I might keep it. Play around with it. I suspect the rope will disappear after use. Okay. That's it.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
So we just leave now. I don't know if we need to worry about anything. Anyone attacking? Our exile is ended. You are truly Sukkala's favored, sent to us as the prophecy has declared. Strange that a surface being as small as yourself could be so powerful. Minsk is not... He's pretty much your height. You're indeed the one sent by Sukkala's prophecy. Our race harbors a long memory, human. You shall not be forgotten in the City of Caverns. Good. Don't you forget about me. Let's go up here. Where are you going?
Faster than Chiktika Fastpaws.
Going the wrong way, faster than Chiktika Fastpaws. Alright, so let's go this way.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
So we need to make our way up and down and then through. So I really enjoyed this dungeon. That's kind of not a dungeon, but it is. The only thing I don't like is all the backtracking we have to do back and forth between the prince and the tooth and... Now we have to make our way back to leave. Everybody catch up. So I wonder if anyone hangs out in here now that they've gone to the surface. Or is this empty now? Oh. You can't climb out of that. Nobody here. And that goes down to the Underdark. But that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.